Today is March 15th, 2010, and it was on this day in 1937 that H.P. Lovecraft died. And so, in his memory, I want to read one of his sonnets from the fungi from Yuggoth, and then a sonnet from one of my own books that I wrote in memory of H.P. Lovecraft. And this is, I'm reading from the paperback. This is the paperback that I took with me when, in 2007, in October, S.T. Joshi took me on a walking tour of Lovecraftian sites in Providence, Rhode Island. And we stood before number 10 Barnes Street, which was the home where Lovecraft lived when he wrote The Fungi from Yuggoth. So I wrote a little memory of standing with S.T. Joshi, who is the world's leading Lovecraft scholar, in front of that house where Lovecraft lived and wrote so many of his magnificent works. So, this is poem 30. It's called Background. I never can be tied to raw new things, for I first saw the light in an old town, where from my window huddled roofs sloped down to a quaint harbour rich with visionings. Streets with carved doorways where the sunset beams flooded old fanlights and small window panes, and Georgian steeples topped with gilded vanes. These were the sights that shaped my childhood dreams. Such treasures left from times of cautious leaven cannot but loose the hold of flimsier wraiths that flit with shifting ways and muddled faiths across the changeless walls of earth and heaven. They cut the moment's thongs and leave me free to stand alone before eternity. Pretty damn awesome. This is from my book, Sesqua Valley and Other Haunts, which was published in hardcover by Delirium Press. I love that cover. Love that cover by Augie Wiedemann. And I wrote a series of sonnets. Most of them really suck because I'm not a good poet. But I named the sequence The Songs of Sesqua Valley. And I'm going to read the last poem, which I called Muse. And this, I wrote this in memory of H.P. Lovecraft. In dark of Providence you dreamed and dreamed, and showed to us a most fantastic place, where sanity unsettled and unseamed, where shadow knelt unto an elder race. With pen and ink you formed your fabled dreamland, and there you conquered space, you conquered time. You penned of wonder in your famous long hand, in graceful prose, in quaint and genteel rhyme. Within our haunted hearts you live forever, with story, essay, poem, we keep alive the genius of your rich, your rare endeavor. Your work will all of mortal time survive. That is not dead which can eternal lie. and with strange eons, even death may die. I love you, HBO. Shalom.